Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Johnson. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Wednesday, the 20th of October. Indian Prime Minister Modi inaugurates Kushinagar International Airport to boost tourism in Buddhist Circuit. Locals protest as Pakistan looks to tighten grip on illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan. And women from warrior community perform dance with swords in Western India. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday inaugurated the Kushinagar International Airport in northern Uttar Pradesh state, with a flight from Sri Lanka becoming the first to touch down at the new airport, which is an endeavor to connect Buddhist pilgrimage sites around the world. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday inaugurated a new international airport at Kushinagar in pole-bound northern Uttar Pradesh state and said his government has taken a number of steps to instill new energy in the aviation sector. Kushinagar is a sacred Buddhist site and is the final resting place of Lord Buddha where he attained salvation or Mahaparinirvana. PM Modi said the airport will boost connectivity and tourism, while also helping develop an entire economic ecosystem in the region and create new job opportunities.
Bharat विश्व भर के बौद्ध समाज की श्रद्धा का आस्था का प्रेरणा का केंद्र है. आज कुशीनगर इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट की ये सुविधा एक प्रकार से उनकी श्रद्धा को अर्पित पुष्पांजलि है. भगवान बुद्ध के ज्ञान से लेकर महापरिनिर्वाण तक ये संपूर्ण यात्रा का साक्षी ये क्षेत्र आज सीधे दुनिया से जुड़ गया है.
The inauguration of Kushinagar International Airport was marked by the landing of the inaugural flight from Colombo, carrying a Sri Lankan delegation, including the 12-member Holy Relic Entourage, bringing the Holy Buddha relics for exposition. PM Modi also participated in an event marking Abhidhamma Day at the Mahaparinirvana Temple. Minister Namal Rajapaksa, who is also the son of Sri Lankan Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, eminent monks from Sri Lanka, Thailand, Myanmar, Bhutan, Nepal, Cambodia, and diplomats from various countries were present on the occasion. Namal addressed the event and thanked PM Modi for extending a grant of $15 million to Sri Lanka to strengthen the Buddhist ties between the two nations. Namal later presented Prime Minister Modi with a Sinhali edition of the Bhagavad Gita, Holy Book of Hindus. It also carries a message from the Sri Lankan Prime Minister. Built at an estimated cost of $35.1, Kushinagar International Airport is part of Modi government's endeavor to connect Buddhist pilgrimage sites around the world. Floods triggered by unseasonal rainfall have continued to wreak havoc in parts of India and neighboring Nepal. The death toll in both the countries crossed nearly 100 on Wednesday, while rescue and relief efforts have been mounted. Authorities in Nepal have warned of more rainfall in the next few days.
Floods triggered by days of unseasonal heavy rainfall have left rivers swollen, blocked roads, washed away bridges and left entire fields of crops submerged in India's northern Himalayan state of Uttarakhand. Officials said on Wednesday more than 45 casualties have taken place due to heavy rains, floods and landslides in the state during the last 3 days. Efforts were on to restore connectivity in the areas which have been cut off as the rain has begun to ease off.
Tolmar ilake mein sare gramino ki fasal dhan ki fasal barbad ho gayi hai aur khet khaliyan beh gaye hain, roado mein sara malwa aa gaya hai.
Uttarakhand's chief minister Pushkar Singh Dhami on Wednesday toured rain hit areas which have bore the brunt of the last 3 days of incessant rainfall and assured all possible assistance.
ke ativrishti se kafi nuksan hua hai aur isliye hum log sabhi jagah ja rahe hain aur sab jagah jo bhi aakalan kar rahe hain aur swayam jaakar jo zarurat ki cheeze hain jo zaruri aapurti hai ya jo aavashyaktaen hain उनको बनाने के लिए हम लोग हर संभव कोशिश कर रहे हैं। हमारी सरकार पूरी तरह से आपदा पीड़ितों के साथ हैं। किसानों का बहुत नुकसान हुआ है, उसका आकलन करके जल्दी उसकी भरपाई करवाने के निर्देश कर रहे हैं।
Meanwhile, in neighboring Nepal, at least 48 people were reportedly killed and around 30 were missing in rain-related incidents, authorities said on Wednesday. The incessant rains over the past 3 days have submerged rice paddy crops and inundated roads and houses. Authorities have warned of more rainfall in the next 2 days.
Moving on. A Canada-based think tank has stated that Pakistan's policy to use Taliban for strategic gain is likely to backfire and the Taliban takeover of Afghanistan will further aggravate terror activities and energize radical organizations in Pakistan. A report.
A Canada-based think tank, IFRAS, the International Forum for Rights and Security, has stated in a report that Pakistan's double games to use Taliban for strategic gain is likely to backfire, and the takeover of Afghanistan by the Islamist group is going to further energize radical organizations in Pakistan. In its report, the think tank said the proliferation of extremist activities in Pakistan will make South Asia and the Middle East more vulnerable to terror threats, affecting the entire global peace in the process. More than 6,000 Pakistani foreign terrorist fighters were hiding in Afghanistan till 2020, even in the presence of the US military, IFRAS said, citing a report by the United Nations. The think tank said the suspicion of playing double game has had the West lose interest in supporting Islamabad. Pakistan has been acting as an enemy nation and uses jihadist terrorists as an arm of their foreign policy. The think tank quoted former US National Security Advisor Lieutenant General H.R. McMaster as saying, "As pressure mounts on Pakistan PM Imran Khan's government to recognize the Taliban government, Maulana Fazlur Rahman, the chief of religious party Jamiat Ulema Islam Fazl, called for a revolution to pull down the government. Following such calls for revolution, the terror outfits in Pakistan may get a boost which may lead to bloodshed," according to the think tank.
Scores of indigenous people and activists gathered in Gilgit-Baltistan recently to oppose Pakistan's latest plans to give non-natives lease-based control of hotels and lands in the illegally occupied region. The protesters blame these are diabolic designs to alter the demography of the region.
Scores of members of a regional political party, activists and indigenous people recently gathered in Gilgit-Baltistan to oppose Pakistan's policy, which they accused were interfering, exploitative and discriminatory. In the latest move, Pakistan has paved the way for non-natives to gain lease-based control of the hotels and lands in the illegally occupied region. Locals lamented they were neither considered nor consulted during the policy drafting process. They said they will never let such anti-native policies get implemented, which are diabolic designs to alter the demography of the region.
तबुजा ये है, जब हमारे इलाके के बारे में हमें इत्मीनान में नहीं लेते हैं, हमसे पूछ नहीं जाते हैं, तो कोई भी इसरात वहाँ पे वफा की तरफ से जो भी फैसला लगा, हमें उसे काबिल कबूल नहीं, हम उसे टोटल ही मुस्तरद करते हैं। तीसरी बात जो है, यहाँ पे हमारी माइनिंग है, मादनियात है, वो लीज का मसला है, और हमसे पूछे बगैर, हमारे मुकामी लोगों को एतमाद में लिए बगैर, वो लीज यहाँ से दूसरे सूबों के लोगों को दिया जाता है, जिससे बेरोजगारी हमारे यहाँ पे बेरोजगारी की शरह भी बढ़ी हुई है।
Over the years, locals have been raising voices against policies of successive Pakistani governments and denial of fundamental rights to people in the region. They blame that any voice of dissent that seeks to resist the exploitative agenda of Pakistan is muzzled with force.
In news from Afghanistan, while a grave humanitarian crisis is unfolding in Afghanistan, the security situation also remains precarious amid an increase in violence across the country in recent weeks. Residents in Afghan capital Kabul hope for improved security under Taliban rule and feel that Islamic Emirate could employ police and army of the former regime who understand the security situation in the region.
Amid an increase in violence across Afghanistan in recent weeks, residents in capital Kabul on Tuesday said they hoped for improved security. Although Taliban authorities have pledged to step up security following recent attacks on Shiite Muslims associated with the Hazara ethnic minority, Kabul residents hoped that the Taliban could employ police and army of the former regime who understand the security situation in the region.
Urdu sabe kara yamasad police sabe kara kichun im nawasta az ulayata jam shuda amada da ulayat Kabul markaz amada u ka balad nesta ke masad dar kucha dar nahya balad basha masad duz barish malum basha ya masad u unamu nafari ke masad chikori بعد می کنه او برشان معلوم باشه
اوس وقت که اغه مشکلاتونه سپخوا او اغه ډیر راټیټ سی وی دي بیا هم که چیرته په افغانستان کې اسلامي امارات لګ دسه توجه وکړي جدیت نه استفاده وکړي بیا هم کېدای شي موږ امیدوار یو اما بیا هم دښمن ده خپل کار کوي خو اوس په راتلونکي کې په دغه مولود شریف کې خلق هم ډیر پریشان دي او په عین زمان کې له پخوا ډار سي اخیستي دي اوس هم ډیر کم امیدوار دي سي دا مراسم سره
At least 41 people were killed and 70 wounded in a suicide attack at a Shiite mosque in southern Kandahar province on October 15. This came a week after a similar incident on a mosque in the city of Kunduz, which killed at least 80 people. Islamic State, a hardline Sunni group, has claimed responsibility for both attacks and dozens of other operations, including small-scale attacks on Taliban targets. The attacks have shocked many in Afghanistan as they have continued since the Taliban seized power in August, tarnishing the movement's claim to have brought peace to Afghanistan after decades of war.
Scores of women from Rajput warrior community performed their traditional dance with swords called Talwar Ras in India's western Rajkot city on Tuesday. The event was organized by the erstwhile royal family of Rajkot to showcase the bravery and valor of women in the community.
Around 200 women donned up in colorful dresses participated in Talwar Ras, a traditional dance form of Rajput warrior clan, which is performed using swords, in Rajkot city of India's western Gujarat state on Tuesday evening. The event was organized by the erstwhile royal family of Rajkot as part of annual celebrations of the Dashera festival, which marks the victory of good over evil, and to showcase the bravery and valor of women in the Rajput community. The participants said they practiced for over a month to coordinate their movements and display their skills with swords.
हमारे राजपूत समाज में तलवार को एक बहुत ही शक्तिशाली अंग माना जाता है जिसके बिना हर राजपूत अधूरा होता है और आज हमने भी ये साबित कर दिया है कि स्त्री कुछ भी कर सकती है
Because in olden times it was always the women of the house who would do the shastra puja and then hand over the shastra to the men to go for war. So it is nothing new that the women have established. It was only that it was forgotten for a few years, which has been revived back again.
The art of sword dance dates back to Mughal era when Rajput women welcomed their men after they returned victorious from a battle. The event aimed to send a message that women are just as powerful as men and can defend themselves and their country.
Folk art is an expression of the world's traditional cultures. An exhibition titled Bangabandhu Folk Art and Folk Music is currently underway in Bangladesh's National Museum in capital Dhaka, aimed at promoting and preserving folk art and culture. The exhibition has brought together artists from across the country through folk arts and is being held in commemoration of Bangladesh founder Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. Artists are showcasing their marvelous handicrafts creation under one roof, which also provides an excellent opportunity for the art-loving public to have a glimpse of all crafts. Artists showcasing their work include paintings, clay and wooden showpieces, embroidery works, brass utensils, jewelry, among others. Visitors strolling through the exhibition can also watch artists' creation before their eyes. The exhibition will come to a close on October 26. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all, Internet's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.